I play the role of Yara. She's a Syrian refugee. Her father was took by the Assad regime forcibly by not committing any crime. And she goes to live in a refugee camp for 2 years with her mother and her three siblings. There she studied English by volunteering with the international nurses. Then they had the opportunity to come here to the UK, and they were placed in an ex-mining village where the people there are suffering, and they are victims in their own way. So when the Syrian refugee came, a lot of like hostility, but also a lot of humane connection happened, and she met TJ, and a friendship, they became friends, and that affects their communities. And it's a very important message to say because it's so relevant. We have a lot of refugees now, and it's a story about hope and about anti-racism story. So, yeah.
I play TJ Ballantyne, and he owns the Old Oak, the pub of the title. It's the last public space in the village. The whole village is going through desperately difficult times. The pub's barely surviving. He doesn't see any way forward, any optimism in his life. And then the Syrian families come into the village, and that tends to be a turning point in his life. And slowly the relationship between TJ and Yara builds, and that is basically the heart of the film.
Can you talk about your experience working with Ken and what you think makes him such a master storyteller?
He loves people. He's very inquisitive, and he's very interested in people, but he has an anger and a desire to fight against inequality and unfairness. And what he does is he identifies stories which have a purpose and which have a massive importance, in my opinion. So he also, when you're filming, he creates a very safe environment, a family environment where you feel absolutely comfortable. And you don't feel afraid to sort of like show your vulnerability. And he's just an incredible man, and it's just been an honour and a privilege to work with him for the last 18 months.
He's really a great and kind man. You, as a human, he sees you. I felt heard and seen. It's great to witness his passion and to see his principles. He directs with such kindness. He trusts you and trusts your instinct as an actor. So it was really, I'm so grateful for it. It's really inspiring. I hope they take that we shouldn't judge people based on their race or religion or their background. I mean, we should give a chance and not to judge immediately, because racism is about judgment, and we should like celebrate our differences, and we should know that we have, as humans, more in common than we have differences, and we really should celebrate it. I mean, we are living on this earth, so, yeah.
It's a small film, you know, we're realistic, it's not going to change the world. You know, all our hope is that, you know, people come to see the film with an open mind, and they take away from it, you know, that we are all human beings, we are all people. You know, the language that's been used at the moment by a lot of politicians is horrendous, you know, in terms of swarms and invasion. You know, it's about humanity and it's about hope. So all my hope is that people come away from the film and it makes people think about, you know, some of the opinions that they've heard and that they've shared. You know, it's all about what we share this planet. And, you know, as Ebla said, we've got a lot more in common than we have separates us. So, yeah, I just hope that it maybe starts a conversation between people. And if that happens, then that's all we can hope for.